The Newtonian reflector has become far and away the world's most popular choice of telescope in large aperture sizes. And it's available in a wide range of mounting types, from Dobsonian to equatorial mount, in all different variety and sizes. And if you're an owner of one of these magnificent telescopes, sooner or later, you're going to want to put your camera attaching to it. Now, in other videos, we've dealt with attaching cameras to eyepieces. In this video, we're going to deal with the particular challenges of attaching an SLR to this type of telescope. Now, I say challenges because if you've tried it already, you may have hit your head on a few difficulties, and you might have actually found that you actually can't get the camera into focus when you're using it with this type of telescope. What we're going to do in this video is give you a bit of an insight into why there's a problem at all and what you can actually do to fix it. First of all, let's just take a quick look at the camera. Now, these are both film cameras. They're both SLRs, but they both use 35mm film. But your digital SLR has exactly the same design fundamentally, especially as regards connection to the telescope. It'll have this large throat. You'll need a T connector to enable you to attach it to the camera. Now, the first problem that we get with this type of camera is the sheer thickness of the body. That's actually the thing that's going to give us the problem when we try to attach this type of camera to any telescope. And I'm going to show you why it's a particular problem with the Newtonian in just a moment. But although these cameras are separated by around about 25 years, you'll notice that for all the difference in design, this one's got motors in it and various other things, and this is a very basic camera from the 60s, the thickness of the body turns out to be about the same at about 45mm. And it's that body thickness that's going to cause a problem for us to get it in focus. First of all, let's just put one of the cameras back together again. We'll put the T-mount on it. Whoops, if we get it the right way around, let's just shove that on. And we're going to put a camera nose piece in there. And we're going to attach this to a telescope in just a moment. So let's just take a closer look at the Newtonian reflector now. So here we are then with our Newtonian telescope, and we want to put our camera on here to take some pictures. But let's just stop and think for a moment. Let's say we've got the target we want to look at. Let's say it's the moon or something. We've got it in focus with the eyepiece in that position. Now, if we're going to take the eyepiece off and we're going to put a camera into place, let's just drop that up there and put our camera in. It stands to reason that we're going to have to move this quite a bit further forward to be able to get the image in focus at the film plane here. Now, as I rack the focuser in, I think you can see one of the things that's actually happening. The focuser tube now is starting to intrude dramatically into the aperture of the telescope. And also another problem, before I've moved it in the 45mm body thickness, the focuser end here actually collides with the body of the focuser system itself. So you can see I physically can't move it in any closer. Now, if you're lucky enough to own a Skywatcher type reflector that's got a 2-inch eyepiece holder, the solution initially can be quite simple. The eyepiece holder has been designed so that you can actually remove that first flange, take that barrel off, remove the nose piece that I've put on the telescope temporarily. Just whip that off, put it down somewhere safe. This can now be screwed in what you might call a low format mode directly onto the front of the camera. And now I can insert that into the holder. And now I've taken off a little bit more of that distance, and I can now get the camera into focus, probably now around about there somewhere. So it's still intruding a bit, but I can actually now get the camera into focus. So that's solution number one, if you're lucky enough to have a Skywatcher. But what about everybody else that might be using a camera that with a non-Skywatcher brand, or a telescope that hasn't got one of these removable extensions? Obviously, take a close look at your telescope. If there's a focuser component you can remove to enable you to get the camera closer, that's a potential solution. But what about in situations where you're not that fortunate? Well, let's just take a look at that in a bit more detail now. Okay, so let's take a look at now a Newtonian reflector with a simpler 1¼-inch eyepiece holder. We've got the same situation we had before. We've got it focused up here. with an eyepiece in it. We're looking at the moon, remember, use your imagination at this point. Take the eyepiece out, we're going to put our camera on, and you notice we've got about 30 millimeters here of inward focuser movement on the telescope before we get that that collision problem. Now bear in mind we've got 45 mil to clear with our camera on here, so we've got a problem. It's actually not going to work. We're not going to be able to move the focuser in far enough to get that image into focus. So what do we do? How do we correct that? Well, this is where our trusty Barlow lens comes to our rescue. Now, we've shown you in other videos how well and what a useful gadget the Barlow is, and it's really going to show its colours here because it really is a useful gadget. Now, the one we've got here is a two-speed Barlow. It's one that's got a 1.5 magnification factor and also a 2x magnification factor. Now, if you did see that video, you remember that one of the points I made in it was to clarify that the Barlow has its influence on the primary focal length of the telescope. Now, if the primary focal length of the telescope is delivering a 30 millimeter amount of in-focus latitude, when you put the Barlow in, that will double too. So by simply taking the camera out, introduce it into the Barlow, put that back into the telescope, we've now basically doubled that 30 mil into 60 millimeters. We need 45 millimeters of adjustment. So we actually know that this camera now is going to come into focus about there somewhere, because we only need to use up 45 millimeters of that that in-focuser movement. So adding a Barlow in front of your camera is a good corrective remedy to be able to get it into focus. Now, do bear in mind, of course, that by adding the Barlow, we're no longer working at prime focus. So a lot of things are going to get quite a bit steeper. The vibration from the camera is going to get a lot worse because we're working with twice the focal length. So you may find you only need to use that little tip. So go with a modest increase in magnification. That's why these two-speed Barlows really are so useful. You can get a lot of variation in the optical setup. Now there you go, I've just added the lens head this time, and that's only going to increase that by 1.5 times. Might work, might not. It's basically going to turn that 30mm into 45 millimeters now, bearing in mind we needed 45 mil, so we might be pretty close to the wire actually getting that focused up. Anyway, the key point here is that amplification lenses of the type that you find in Barlows are a great strategy for being able to get the camera in closer so that you can actually bring it to focus. The only downside, remember, is that by increasing the focal length or the apparent focal length of the telescope when you're using it with the Barlow, you are going to put more pressure on your guiding and tracking and all that kind of thing. But of course, for fairly short duration photographs of the moon and bright planets and that kind of thing, it's going to be fairly straightforward. That's it for now.